Hi there, it's Borko from Plumsail. In today's video, I will show you how to create an interactive org chart for SharePoint and Microsoft Teams using SharePoint user profiles as a data source. Let's dive in. Step one is to create user profiles. I will assume that you already have created users in your Microsoft 365 Admin Center. So these users will be added automatically to your SharePoint user profiles, and in this case you don't have to do anything. Only if you're adding custom properties for assistants and dotted line managers, you have to set it up properly. To use this option, you must go to Manage User Properties and add those properties by clicking on the new property button and add one by one. Your SharePoint user profile should look something like this. So you will populate data for your employees as per company standard, and I assume you will populate this field for manager as well. This is used to build the org chart structure, and it is necessary. Step two is to add org chart to our site. So click to edit the site and click on this plus sign to add the web part to the preferred spot on the site. I assume that you already have added Plumsail org chart to your SharePoint, and in that case, just search for Plumsail org chart. But if you haven't added Plumsail org chart to your SharePoint, I will include a link to the video in the description section so you can follow step-by-step instructions and add it to your SharePoint. Also, there will be a link to 30-day free trial with no credit card required. Simply register your account and test it out. Also, please like and subscribe, more interesting content coming your way. Now, let's get back to step three to configure org chart. So, click on configure button and you will see options to select from different data sources. This time, we will use user profiles. For this data source, no additional configuration of data source is required, as I mentioned before. Just go to the wizard until the end. Org chart loads hierarchy from SharePoint user profiles based on managers and account name properties. In case you want to configure assistants and dotted line managers, you will have to change the mapping below if you're using custom properties to store this information. How to add assistants and dotted line managers is explained in separate videos, and I will leave the links in the description section. The same applies for vacancies. For now, we will click Next. In the Filtration tab, I will have to choose a root employee from my demo data. But if your user profiles are structured to showcase your employees and their managers properly, you don't have to do it. Org chart will automatically detect it based on the current user hierarchy. So basically, org chart goes through all of your employees and searches for the first employee without a manager. In Design tab, we can choose from different designs and layouts, but for now, we will skip this part. In the Template tab, we can choose what to be displayed in the box template, which is visible as the org chart loads. Then we can choose what's visible in the Tooltip template and Search template as well. Select field for picture URL is detected automatically if named correctly. Otherwise, if you have created a custom property for this purpose, you will have to select that field name. Please note in here, if you copy the picture URL from your SharePoint library and save it to user profiles property, you will have to do as following to ensure that the link to the picture is correct. Open your documents library in SharePoint and go to the folder where you saved employees' photos. Then select the photo of your employee and click on the share button. You will get this pop-up window for the link settings and select people with existing access and hit apply, then copy the link. Then you will have to remove some parts of the link as shown on the screen. Now you have a correct link to the picture. Once we publish it, we can go back at any time and reconfigure it. From here, we can add it to Microsoft Teams as a tab and share it with our employees. There is a separate video on how to do this. And that's all for this video. Please check out our org chart playlist to learn more. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you soon.